Patel, Shirpur Professor Abhijit.
Our heartiest congratulations to you for hearty congratulations to you for arranging such a wonderful workshop and our participants on the behalf of our participants. They have really worked hard for this workshop and they have been kept busy like with all the tutorials and the quiz and the lab sessions going in parallel. And we are also planning to start one electro and for final year mechanical, so we'll be in need of your guidance regarding that. And one of our college nearby college, they also want to contribute in that, so we wish to continue with this about the solar PV further. So some participants wants to talk to you about
Good afternoon, sir. Myself Shailaja Patil. On behalf of R.C. Patil Institute of Technology, Shirpur, I am very thankful to member of IIT Bombay for arranging such wonderful workshop. Not just workshop, but the empowerment of program. We all enjoyed the practical sessions, online quiz, lectures of Professor Solanki and Fernandes. Before this workshop, we had many doubts, but after attending all lectures, our all doubts are cleared. So we all assure that the concepts, information information of solar cell given by you will be used for students' project, practicals, for research purpose. Also, I am very thankful to our principal sir, HOD sir, and coordinator Mr. A.H. Khadke sir, for his continuous efforts and arranging this workshop and smooth conduction of practical sessions, online speech arrangement, tutorials, and of course, for nice tea, breakfast, and lunch. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, sir. Myself, Deepak Sonone. First, I would like to thanks for giving an opportunity for this workshop. Especially thanks for Solanki, sir. This workshop is very fruitful for us, but 10 days are very short. So I kindly request you to give more days for specially PV system design. Sir, in future, arrange workshop on application-based design, development, and also manufacturing of PV system. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, all the participants, the coordinator, Professor Abhijit, thank you very much for taking part. I think one more participant want to say something very quick.
Sir, first of all, I want to thank you. You have given such a good knowledge, and I want to only say that before this workshop, I was only 1 centimeter deep in the knowledge of solar photovoltaic, and you have taken me up to 100 meters deep in this workshop. And my kind request that henceforth try to provide some more time so that we can conduct individually the practicals and get the enjoyment and knowledge through the practicals only. Thank you, sir.
I'm sure if you go deeper into the knowledge, you are going to enjoy more and more. So continue your journey and go to the kilometer depth level. Thank you, coordinator. Thank you very much. Now we'll go to Rajaram Bapu Institute of Technology, Islampur.
Congratulations, sir, to complete this great workshop successfully to your team, as well as thanks for giving this opportunity to work as a workshop coordinator. As well as my director is agree with for this photovoltaic cell to take this as a open source elective. My participants having some feedback, I will hand over to the Ajay Patil.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Ajay Patil. I am participant here on behalf of all our participants. I congratulate you, and also I am thankful to Professor Jadhav sir because he has taken care about all the information and all type of facilities over here. The course is very good. It's a basically it's an interdisciplinary type of course. Many students from different disciplines, they are working in this area. And one more thing is that the theoretical concepts are supported by practical. That is also a very good thing. And what the facilities what we have observed here, well, this is our first experience to see this type of course, that is video conference type of our remote station type of relay. So I am very much thankful to you and your team. And also, I am very much thankful to the coordinator, Professor Jadhav, once again. Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Abhay Patil. Everyone has said congratulations and given a vote of thanks to people. But additionally, I want to give my vote of thanks to our coordinator, Professor K.U. Jadhav, sir, and all his teammates for making this workshop possible for us. Over here, the arrangements are so beautifully done, starting from the breakfast session till the lunch session. Afterwards, we had a short tea session too. So each and every minute considerations are taken by him, and I want to give my vote of thanks to him for that purpose.
Okay, thank you very much. The participant actually can clap for Professor Jadhav. Why don't you do that? And we'll visit the next center. Thank you. Shastra University, John Bosco, Professor John Bosco.
Yes, sir. Very good afternoon to all the professors on the dais. On behalf of Shastra University and on behalf of participating faculty friends, I sincerely thank IIT Bombay and MNRE for initiating this mission on solar photovoltaics, and a special thanks to the two inspiring sources of energy, Professor Solanki and Professor Fernandes. And your lectures are a meaningful value addition for every one of us. At the same time, I thank Professor Mukta Atre for the synchronized organization of this event. And also, I assure you, all the professors, that definitely we will have an exclusive course on photovoltaics in the School of Electrical and School of Mechanical in the coming semester. And definitely this will be a chain action. Thank you very much, sir. Now I will give you to one of the participants.
Good afternoon, sir. At this juncture, sir, I would like to thank MHRD and IIT Bombay and our remote center, Shastra University. Really, it's an amazing, wonderful lecture. And then, again, I thank MHRD and IIT B for showing off two stars in front of ourselves. One star is Mr. Professor Solanki, sir. Another star is Dr. Fernandes, sir. Really amazing, wonderful lecture, sir. At this time, sir, I would like to say one request. If time permits, you can discuss about research topics related to in this field, sir. Thank you. Now I give to another participant, sir.
The facilities provided by the Shastra University is excellent, and for the last 10 days we are getting excellent lectures. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much for the IST for providing us a wonderful lectures for the last 10 days. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you to all. Thank you, Professor John. You have been really active participant, and you have also taken a great interest in the coordinating it. So thank you very much, and it is nice to know that you are going to conduct start elective course. And as you mentioned, the chain reaction is what we are looking for. So this should continue in a chain reaction in the knowledge of transfer of photovoltaics. So please take part in that. Thank you. We'll go to SGS ITS, and after that Shivaji University, Kolhapur, and after that Sri Jayacham Rajendra College, Karnataka.
We are thankful to your team for conducting such a wonderful course, and we would like to have such course, such opportunity every time. Our head, Professor M.L. Nasir, is here. I'm handing over the mic to him. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much for organizing such a very interesting and interdisciplinary areas, IST workshop on solar photovoltaic areas. This particular workshop enhanced the interdisciplinary research in my institutes. And the second part of the article, which is well supported by the theory classes and tutorials, is very much enjoyed by my participant. And in order to materialize this particular workshop, I am very much thankful for my participant that they have submitted a proposal for a joint research among the institute faculty that empowered the street light of the institute, and that help in cutting down the electric power bill for the institute. We are very much thankful for the entire team of the IIT Bombay, and special thanks to Professor Solanki, Professor Fernandes, Professor Fatak, and Madam Atre, and the whole team which is contagion this for the workshop. Today is the great day for me as the GS Institute of Technology and Science is hosting this particular 22nd of December, the alumni day, and I am happy to say that Professor Solanki is one of the alumni of GSITS. Any participant again want to share something for you?
Okay, thank you.
This is for you, Professor Solanki. You've got some exceptional teaching skills. And one suggestion is that even if you start a workshop on teaching skills.
Okay, thank you.
One suggestion is if you start a workshop on teaching skills, it will have a similar kind of response as this workshop does.
Okay, I'll do that. I see my teacher, Professor Vevare, also among the audience. I would like to request if Professor Vevare can make a brief comment.
Thank you very much, Professor Solanki, for giving the floor. I know your face was very tired for a few days. Today I am seeing all smiles on your face. So obviously 800 people are extremely happy and excited, and they want to take these things ahead. I am very happy to note that somebody mentioned from somewhere that there is a Solar Energy Society of India. And it's very good that such type of societies will now do more amount of work. Things are going from lab to the land, and I know lands are very dear to Professor Solanki because ultimately it's a very big geographical area country, and I'm very sure that with your enthusiastic and energy, and of course with Professor Fernandes and Mukta Atre's enthusiasm and involvement into it, the whole thing will go into big way, and maybe we may not be alive at that day, but 25 years right from now, the energy into this country will come from non-conventional like solar energies, which will be free to everybody. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot for giving me the opportunity.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you, Basant. You've done the nice job and conducting this at GSITS. Thank you very much. Yeah, Shivaji University, please go ahead. Professor Pradeep, please go ahead.
This is Solanki and the rest of the dignitaries on the dais. I really thankful to Professor Solanki and Dr. B.G. Fernandes, and it is a truly appreciated event at my center. For that, I must congratulate to Professor Solanki and the team of IIT. Just a day before yesterday, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Shivaji University visited to our center, and he has conveyed his vote of appreciation to you, if you could remember. So it is nicely arranged by the IIT Mumbai, and we are really appreciated that AVU software, which is very helpful for doing such events. Without wasting times, I will hand over participants to just convey their view.
Good afternoon, sir. Myself, Mr. Sindhe Vinay, Principal, New Polytechnic, Kolhapur. For me, it was a great experience to have such video conferencing virtual learning workshop. Such activities should be encouraged by MHRD and continued in different disciplines of engineering, especially topics in recently developing fields, led by an excellent resource person from all over IITs in India. It will percolate the recent technologies to the technocrats all over the India and may help to develop and create the research attitude in the young engineers. I now thank to Professor Solanki and Professor Fernandes and the manager of this IT department, Mrs. Atre Madam, from our Shivaji University team. Thank you, sir. I will hand over to Mr. Sawant.
Good afternoon, everybody. Sir, we are very fortunate, we feel very fortunate that we have become part of this program, wonderful program, where we get a chance to interact with the IIT people, because we have lots of respect for the IIT faculties and IIT Bombay particularly. So we feel we are very thankful and grateful to all of you, your team. Just a few things I would like to mention, that what I like or what we like about Solanki sir is his simplicity in every respect, and his smile. So sir, please keep smiling. Just one more thing. We also listen the address given by Professor Fatak. Professor Fatak's address was very inspiring and very motivated. So just a small suggestion that if you're able to arrange his address at the starting of your workshop, that will be very effective. Thank you, sir. and just to one more candidate.
Good afternoon, everybody. Myself, Vijay Kumar Kurishifti from IIT College of Engineering in Kolhapur here. So firstly, I want to congratulate you for the success of the event, which was really efficient and effective. And secondly, I want to thank you for all the tons of information you have provided to us and the valuable information and knowledge which has really helped us in improving our knowledge. And one more thing I want to say is I was just imagining we lecturers all over the country are lying like a solar cell who are really unconnected and isolated. So this MHRD, MNRE and this IIT Mumbai has provided the real connectivity. And you, sir, you, Solanki sir and Fernandes sir has provided the bias and the right illumination. So now the current has really generated and the power is being getting generated. So the only thing is this support has to be continuous and the biasing and the illumination has to be continuous all over the future, I would say. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I am sure Professor Fernandes will ensure you the bias and I will ensure you the light so that the current can flow continuously. And if the current flows continuously, I am sure we all keep smiling. So thank you very much, Professor Pradeep, for organizing this at your center. Thank you. I'll go to Jaicham Rajan College, Professor Anand Murthy.
Good afternoon, Professor Solanki, Professor Moudgalya and Professor Vashi. The program has ended successfully and this requires a lot of team effort. This shows that this team effort is there at IIT Bombay. So it is because of the teamwork, the workshop has gone off very well. Now I will request one of our participants to give the feedback.
Good afternoon, sir. We appreciate the efforts taken by you and your team. Especially your lecture plan was excellent. So will there be any further course so that we can electrify our homes with a solar PV module? This will certainly help our Karnataka government. We have electricity problem. And a big thanks to our coordinator, Professor Anandamurthy, for all the arrangement he has made. Thank you.
Hello, sir. Sir, I am studying in 7th semester Bachelor of Engineering, Electrical Engineering. So I have taken this solar photovoltaic course as an elective. Our sir has provided as an elective. So about 40 to 50 students we have taken this elective, and because of this elective I was able to assist in the lab activities as a teaching assistant here, and I'm very happy for the course, sir. We have been reading your textbook since 4 months, and we have really found it very nice, sir. And the fundamentals and everything about solar photovoltaics, like solar PV technologies and all, which we had thought we could never learn, we have learned it, sir. And really it's very enjoying, and also the kits have been used by us. And I would like to ask whether there is any research openings at IIT Bombay for our bachelor students, and if it's possible to provide some engineering projects at IIT Bombay regarding solar photovoltaics, it will be very helpful for us, sir. And also as engineers we would like to contribute to the society in terms of power to India by learning this solar photovoltaics course. So we would like to get some opportunity in IITs and some government sectors to help in empowering the society, sir. And also we would like to publicize this all over our juniors and also among our society. And one more question, sir. It would be better if you provide the AVU software for Linux in Linux version, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. I would like to thank, I'm sorry we are running late, so let me go ahead. So thank you very much. First of all, I would like to thank Professor Anand Murthy. Again, he has been taking a lot of interest, and it's so nice that he's already running an elective and many students are getting take part in the elective. AVU software under the Linux based is under the development. And in terms of the projects at IIT Bombay, if you can visit our center NCPRE, you know what we are doing, and you can apply and write to various faculty members, and if there is a possibility, we will take it. So thank you very much, Professor Murthy, for coordinating this at your center. Okay, now we will go to SVIT Surat, Dr. Ashish Panchal.
After completion of successful of this program, and one of the biggest thing is that the kit which is provided by Professor Solanki and the demonstration provided by the electrical department IIT Bombay, that will be utilized for our elective course in M.Tech for all the experiments we perform by the students. And now I am handing over to one of the participants for the feedback.
Good afternoon, sir. I am from SP University, Asinja. I think I am one of the candidate with the lowest qualification, BST passed out in 1980. But I am doing my work in wind solar hybrid system from last 6-7 years. And I have designed about 200 systems. But I did all the thing practically. I was not having a proper theoretical knowledge. So whatever the things available in the market, I used to design the things and get it done. Recently I had developed my house with a wind solar hybrid system. I am having the lift working on the solar entirely. And here I got the good knowledge. I am very much thankful for giving me the admission. So now I have a knowledge to justify my things theoretically. Actually I was not aware with the theoretical aspects. So I am very much thankful to the center and your team to give me a chance to go through this workshop. Thank you, sir.
Lot has been said about the training content and experimental work. What, according to me, the best part of the training session is we got learning experience from IIT faculties even without getting admission to the IIT. So that is the best exposure for any teacher in engineering cadre. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much to the, all the participants. Thank you to the coordinator for organizing at SVNIT. SVNIT was the center which received the highest number of registrations. Okay, then we are going to the Tejpur University. Dr. Bora.
I would like to thank you, Fernandes sir and Mukta ma'am for giving us this opportunity to take part in this wonderful workshop. The course content is very good. We are enjoying the lecture session as well as the practical. It is a nice experience for me as well as our participant. Then now I hand over my microphone to one of our participants.
Hello, Dr. Professor Solanki. Thank you very much for the course. It's an excellent course. We enjoyed it throughout the duration, and we look forward to future this type of course in the near future. And I now hand over the mic to one of the participants.
Hello, sir. Good evening. I'm P.K. Bora from the Tejpur University. Sir, I had a lot of doubt regarding the solar panels. After attending, I got a lot of idea and a lot of thanks to you, sir. So I hope in future, that type of platform, I will got it. Lot of thanks to you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much to all the participants. Thank you the coordinator for organizing it. Professor Prakash, VIT Nagpur.
I'm Dr. P.S. Kulkarni, workshop coordinator here. Good afternoon, sir. So we have nearly 27 participants at the center, and we are already running one elective renewable system since 2003. With the help of your kids, we are going to start the laboratory also. So thanks a lot for that. Our honorable director was here at the beginning of this function. Now I hand over to participant for their feedback.
Good evening, sir. I am Dr. Sridevi Barsi. My hearty congratulations to Professor Solanki, Professor Fernandes, and the program. Since the participation is for multidisciplinary, so pre-workshop must read resource. would have been useful for people who are coming from various backgrounds to prepare for this course. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Hello, myself, Mrs. Giripinde from VNIT Nagpur. Hello. So I would like to tell you, though you were teaching us from IIT Bombay, but it seemed that you were at our center. So it was so live. Your lectures were so live, and we enjoyed your every lecture. It was so knowledgeable, and I think if such type of program is continued further, that will increase the awareness between the students, teachers, and next generation engineers. I think it will be, instead of only computer science, electronics engineer, the next generation engineers will be solar energy engineers. And we liked your program very much, and hope in future we will attend such type of programs again. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much. Very nicely said that the next generation boom of engineers should be in the solar engineer, and I think let us hope that this is the beginning of that. Thank you, Professor Kulkarni. You have been again very active coordinator both while coming being at IIT Bombay and at your center also. So thank you very much. VIT Vellore.
I am workshop coordinator of VIT. Thank you very much for giving an opportunity to organize the workshop here. As per the schedule, the program went very well, and we have conducted the lab successfully with the help of the teaching faculties. And here I could see the impact as the participants started discussing the ways to include the experiments in the laboratory, the regular curriculum, and you can expect an outcome in the near future. And I hand over the mic to some participants.
Good evening, sir. The workshop is very well planned, and we enjoyed the session as a student doing lab manuals, preparing for quizzes, tutorials. All the 10 days we are so busy in, and we didn't think of taking class from tomorrow onwards. It's so useful, sir. Your photovoltaic design, standalone PV system design is so useful, and Fernandes sir's power electronics design is so useful, sir. And please provide one example with the power electronic components for a complete photovoltaic system, because we want some design. So if one example is included in the module, means it will be very useful, sir. Very, very thank you very much for the Solanki sir, Fernandes, and coordinator Dr. Arun. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, thank you very much, Professor Arun. It was really nice. Thank you very much for coordinating, and at your center also, it was a very active center, and I request all the participants to give a big applause for Professor Arun. Now we are going to Baramati.
First, I would like to congratulate you and your team for giving us a nice opportunity to get acquainted with the fundamental clearance of solar cell. We have really enjoyed all the sessions, especially the practical sessions which we have to perform on the terrace. So once again, congratulate you and your team. Now I will hand over mic to my one of the colleagues. He will give feedback for the session.
Hello, sir. Baramati is emerging as a education hub next to Pune in West Maharashtra. So first of all, I thank you for choosing this college as a remote center. This college has a very excellent infrastructure with all necessary systems and instruments. Management is very dynamic and has very good vision in the field of technical education. Most of the participants in this center were from science faculty. In this center, lectures and practical sessions were organized very sincerely and seriously. Of course, this credit goes to our coordinator, Professor Disley. I appreciate the efforts taken by IIT Bombay faculty for imparting the technological information about solar photovoltaic in a very simple and lucid manner. We are impressed by the teaching methodology and your patience during question answer sessions. In future, we will be definitely participating in such a workshop. We in our college already doing some experiments on this photothermal photovoltaic. I assure you that all of us will try to implement some of the ideas that we have studied in this workshop. Thank you, sir.
Gorakhnath Gaikwad, sir, for in-depth study and research of solar PV, we want a continuous interaction. Sir, is it possible to interact with both of you, Chetan Solanki sir and Fernandes sir, on video chat? And what is your time for it? we want always in contact with you for the above said purpose.
So what I was saying that you already utilized your quota for this year, and we can definitely be in touch with each other through the Moodle. But yes, I think it is possible in this today's world that we can have video communication with each other when if it is required. Otherwise, web interface will be a good medium. So thank you, Baramati, for taking the center and really conducting it well. We have been getting a lot of questions from Baramati throughout the course. Okay, I'll go for one more participant. Go ahead.
Hello, sir. Sir, please, sir. Sir, myself is Pradeep Patil. I'm a physics teacher, sir. Sir, first of all, I'm thankful to you and also Fernandes, sir, for this total informative course. This full course was total knowledge based. And being all of we are the teachers here, I am giving you the assurance that all we teacher will utilize all the materials you people have given for us, and we will share with all our students, sir. Basically, we are UG teachers, sir. So one thing I would like to suggest, sir, in the complete schedule, one module has to be included on the research module. In that module, we are expecting actually what is the current status of all these solar cell or whatever topic on which the workshop is going on. And we are expecting some problems, sir, so that our teachers, those who are working, who are doing the research in the college, they can contribute some research, sir. So that is why we are expecting the problems and some topics also. Even if you give to the college teacher, they will help for research, sir. And of course, your cooperation will be also needed, sir. Another one request is, sir, suppose if we arrange the educational visit of our UG student to NCPRE, is it possible, sir? Will you give the permission to us, sir? And what is the procedure for that visit, sir? Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. So, first of all, to get the what is the research going on or what we are doing at IIT Bombay, the NCPRE site is the best site. You can visit www.ncpre.iitb.ac.in to get the topic. Regarding the visit, yes, it would be possible. We are setting up the lab, and I think another couple of months it will be fully fledged. And once it is there, I'm sure it is not only the visit of the lab, but some of you can actually come and do the experiments. So that would be possible in future. Nirjali, back to you. Anup.
For such a wonderful workshop that you have been conducting right from the beginning. I also thank all my participants that they have actively participated in the entire workshop. Although we had been some problems initially that I already communicated to you regarding our strikes and all these things. But after that, we conducted the workshop very successfully. Mostly the people are from physics background, but they have gained a lot from the experiments that they have conducted. And I hope that there will be some more workshops from IIT Bombay that we'll be conducting with you. So now I would like to pass mic to some of my participants over here.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Professor D.C. Mohanta from Assam. I am participating in usually the workshop. And on behalf of all of the participants of our workshop, I want to thank you. And our coordinator was very energetic, and all the faculty members of this staff are very much cooperative. And I request you to provide some extra, logistic support regarding the specific geographical location of the Northeast, because you know that this location is not very much conducive regarding the solar power, as we know. So I request the IIT Bombay and our ministry to take initiative to harness solar power in this region. Very much thank you, sir. Kudos to Professor Solanki et al. And the IIT Mumbai staff. Thank you.
Now I would pass mic to one of my senior professor, Professor P.D. Kaishyap from our electrical department.
Sir, good evening. The workshop has been really very successful. You deserve all appreciation for it, and further, I'll say that if possible, you can extend these facilities
which are away from your centers. Like I belong to NIT Arunachal Pradesh, and which has recently started, and we would like to have such facilities over there. Please tell us the process, how we can get into this and get your support in this field. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much to all the participants. Thank you, Anoop, for coordinating it. Regarding setting up similar facility, I think Professor Fatak has mentioned yesterday that they are preparing a document which will actually highlight how to set up this facility at the other center. So thank you very much. And now we'll hand over to Dr. Mukta. So we have visited all the centers, and it is really very exciting to see the participant sitting there, and so many in number from all the centers. Thank you all for your appreciation, and we also appreciate the efforts that are put by the coordinators and participants for being there for 10 days and having acquired this knowledge on photovoltaic. I request you to start the chain reaction and train your own student and continue this journey of learning and teaching. Thank you. Dr. Mukta.
Thank you all, and it was really nice listening to all of you sharing your experiences with us. It was very heartening for all the people here, the especially our team who has been working on this workshop, to actually look at the people for whom they have been working. And now I request Professor Kannan Moudgalya, who is a member of the Standing Committee on the NME ICT, to say a few words about the NME ICT in IIT Bombay. Professor Moudgalya.
Professor Chetan Solanki, Professor Fernandes, Professor Vasi, all the heads of institutions visiting your remote centers. It gives me a lot of pleasure to give this brief address on having completed this course successfully. I recall the time when we went for funds to MHRD. This is a project, this particular component of our project, where we have to pay TA, DA to more than 1,000 teachers at a time. It involved a lot of expenditure, and MHRD was gracious enough to give the required funds. I, of course, do recall the discussions regarding synchronous versus asynchronous mode of education, because for the asynchronous type of education, we have a very good example, namely NPTEL, extremely popular. So there were questions about should we also go ahead with synchronous education. The main question at that time was, is it scalable? Is it possible to conduct a class for 1,000 teachers? Is it possible to conduct an interactive program for 1,000 people? And finally, after a lot of deliberations, it was decided that we should persist with both the models. One of the benefits of synchronous learning is that it is highly scalable. You can interact, you can organize such programs. In fact, a regular class itself can be transmitted. So because of all these reasons, MHRD decided that it would persist with this synchronous mode of education also. Professor Fatak, of course, from day one believed that synchronous is the way to go. And of course, there were questions about how to answer the questions raised by lots of participants from across the country. If everybody starts asking questions, how does one answer them? So at that time, Professor Fatak said, well, let that happen first, then we will worry about answering that question. But we have seen technology being able to address many of the issues. At that time, there was no Moodle. When this program, synchronous transmission, started from this very seminar room more than 10 years ago, as a part of a distance education program that Professor Fatak started at the time. Moodle was not there at the time. We also didn't have AVU at the time. We didn't have good bandwidth at the time. So we have many better tools now. I'm pretty sure that with time we will have further better tools, even more exciting modes of communication. I'm pretty sure that we'll be able to handle these problems. These are not difficult problems at all. We should be able to handle them. What was not realized at that time was the reach that this would give. We were really delighted that about 50% of the participants are ladies. This could never have happened in a typical QIP or IST program that we conduct at IIT Bombay. That's number one. That we are able to reach out to remote areas and far-flung areas like Arunachal Pradesh, Northeast and so on, that as if they are just next door. And in some of our programs, people from Srinagar participated, even braving local strikes and things like that. This would not have been possible. Reaching out to more than 1,000 people would have taken 30 to 40 years through our regular QIP program. And by the time the course would have been obsolete, and by the time we accommodated anybody gets nominated to such a QIP program for a 30% event, would have taken many years for people to get qualified, and by the time they would have lost all their energy, enthusiasm and interest. So this has proven to be extremely powerful kind of methodology. Of course, it has been mentioned that this program should be useful for conducting research, to offer many more courses and so on. All of these are possible. MHRD is really keen to spread this. You would have heard the MHRD secretary mentioning these on the first day during her inaugural talk, that that we should replicate this program in all the other places. In fact, she has also urged Professor Fatak to also invite faculty members from other places, not to stay only with IIT Bombay, get the experts from other IITs and also other institutions to start with. For example, we could start with NITs. Professor Fatak is in the process of writing letters to the directors of NITs, inviting them to nominate some of their best faculty members. Eventually, it will be possible to use this methodology to reach out to large numbers of people. So, I just want to give an outline of brief overview of some of the activities that are funded by MHRD's mission, National Mission on Education through ICT. My dear colleague Professor Vasi called some of these as weapons of mass instruction, and I would like to talk about some more of these. One of the important programs that running at IIT Bombay is the open source software promotional program. This is extremely important for our country. There are some projections made by IIM Bangalore that on proprietary software alone, the India as a whole will be spending about 20,000 crore a year, and they project about 100,000 crore during the next plan period. And this is and of course 80% of it roughly is expected to be on Windows and Office, because that is the one that is a commercial software used widely by almost everybody. So, money is one thing that we should be spending so much money on proprietary software when we have equivalent as good if not better software available free of cost, especially when our, for example, our school system is in bad shape. We need more teachers, we need to pay better salaries, we need blackboards. so on and so forth, should we not look at open source software as an alternative? At IIT Bombay, we are working on promoting Scilab and Python. I am directly involved in the Scilab effort, so I just want to say a few words about it. Scilab is an excellent equivalent to MATLAB. Scilab is created by INRIA. One of the very popular organizations using this software is CNES France. You can say that it is equivalent of our ISRO. You know that CNES launches Ariane rockets, and it has placed many of our satellites into orbit, and I can assure you that most of them are based on calculations using Scilab. I want to just tell a story about one of my colleagues, Professor Kavi Arya, has a project manager, and his name is Naidu. He explained one difficulty he got into. They apparently had a startup with a specific product that would help locate video clips based on emotions. And they were almost apparently they had taken the help of a faculty member to come up with this search engine, and it required some signal processing fast Fourier transform and tools like that. And apparently that person had developed the whole thing, a professor developed the whole thing in MATLAB. Finally, when this team wanted to launch their product, they were ready with it. Then this startup said that let's launch it. Then they found out that they had to acquire specific permissions, and then so that they could distribute executables in very large numbers. And at that time they found that it was very expensive. As a matter of fact, this company had to would have incurred more than 1 crore to buy the required software licenses. And then because it was a startup, it could not afford, and they at that time tried to replace that with open source equivalent. And then within 2 months, unfortunately, apparently Google came up with a similar product, and this company had to in fact close down. It is extreme, we do not realize this in academia, that industry often finds it extremely difficult to afford expensive software, and we do not understand that in academia, because software is either free, or the industry gives software industry gives us bulk permissions to use. But remember, our students can't use them when they leave the premises of our academic institutions. It is important to be socially aware, responsible, that we should train our children on open source software. Who knows, some of them may become entrepreneurs, and they can come up with really outstanding products, and they can which can compete at a which can produce extremely competitive products at much lower price. So I think it's a social responsibility that all of us should take seriously. We have at IIT Bombay in our open source software effort, apart from Scilab as a standalone software, we are exploring the possibility, we are exploring the use of Scilab with XCOS plus HART, which is a real-time access toolbox, and also Comedy, which is a device driver toolbox, as a excellent equivalent to LabVIEW. In case you are interested, in case anybody is interested, you can get in touch with us. The other product that we are using is GNU Radio. GNU Radio gives a very good front end, so that you can use sliders, knobs, and so on, which can be used, so the values of programs can be changed while runtime, while at the same time giving excellent graphic user interface. We are also using a combination of KiCad, NGSpice and Scilab as an equivalent for PSpice, KiCad for PCB layout, and then once it is done, export the software to export the netlist to NGSpice and get the simulation results displayed. And one of the things that students want to know is, you know, why do these, what is the theoretical basis for the result? Sometimes the students are not able to understand from NGSpice, and that is when Scilab simulations come. One of our PhD students in electrical engineering has developed this, so that it is possible to send and also get the results from Scilab. You can actually see the differential equations, optimization and so on and so forth. That also looks very promising. Virtual labs is another very important component of this National Mission on Education through ICT that the secretary mentioned the other day. It's an extremely important add-on to the theory courses. Of course, you have seen a taste of that through this course, through the photovoltaic cell course. But just imagine having this for every one of our courses. That will be amazing, and the hands-on capability. And there are excellent programs, excellent projects that are coming up. Unfortunately, we do not have time to go through that. I think I have already taken substantial time. I would like to conclude my address with something very close to my heart. I am spending most of my time on this project called Spoken Tutorials. Spoken Tutorials is the one of the components of this Talk to a Teacher project, along with 1000 teacher training program. And another important thing I in fact forgot to mention, called Ask a Question. In fact, there was a question from Baramati, can we not discuss, you know, once in a while, can we continue to discuss with Professor Solanki and also Professor Fernandes? As a matter of fact, we have this Ask a Question sessions. At present, we are doing this only in electrical engineering, and those of you who post questions in that would have actually seen Professor Fernandes answering questions posed by students. At present, we do this on every Thursday 4 to 5. We recently started an experiment to offer this 1 hour session for open source software. We can certainly extend this to photovoltaic cell. It will be eminently possible. It will be possible to have experts also to come from various places to give solutions. Okay, back to Spoken Tutorials. These are 10-minute instructional material for self-learning, and we have created them in such a way that experts are not required to conduct these workshops. The website for this project is spoken-tutorial.org. We have now we are conducting workshops on LaTeX, Scilab, PHP, Python, Linux, and we have our collaborators creating several other instructional materials, instructional modules. These workshops are extremely popular. In fact, it is likely that students from some of your own colleges would have participated. We have reached a level of 200 workshops a month now. In fact, we will complete 1000 workshops by March 31st, and about 40 students are undergoing each of these workshops. So, we may even complete about 50,000 student training by the end of March 31st. And we also conduct pre-workshop test and post-workshop test. We give certificates based on the performance. It's really I'm really delighted to know that the students like this very much. These are some of the projects that are happening. There are a few other projects at IIT Bombay. One of them is Oscar, or the animation project done by Professor Sridhar Iyer, who creates animations to support recorded courses like NPTEL. We also have a program by Professor Kavi Arya, who has very exciting programs on embedded systems. Of course, you already know about NPTEL, so I would not talk about it. So with this, I want to thank you for your enthusiastic participation in this program. Congratulations on having completed this program. Please do spread this. There was a mention of what are other courses. Professor Fatak already talked about the 10,000 teacher training program on research methodologies that will happen in the next summer. As a pilot to that, in about a month time, perhaps the last weekend of January, we will have a one day workshop on how to write better papers, and this is going to be anchored by my colleague Professor Sahana Murthy, faculty member in our interdisciplinary program on education technology. The context is that we have conference Technology for Education. It is going to happen next summer in Hyderabad, and Professor Sahana Murthy is one of the is the program committee chair, and she is concerned that we should get a large number of papers to this IEEE conference on education technology. So this one day conference is to talk to people about how to write better papers, so that we can accommodate more of your more of your contributions. So there will be more mailings on this. There will be many more courses, and Dr. Mukta Atre and her team will be sending you emails. Please keep track of it, and then we are really delighted by your questions, and we hope to attend to all of them sooner if not later. Thank you very much for your patience. Goodbye.
Thank you, Professor Moudgalya. And now I request Professor Vasi, NCPRE, to tell us about the activities at NCPRE and also his observations on this workshop. Professor Vasi.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Atre, Professor Kannan Moudgalya, Professor Chetan Solanki, Professor B.G. Fernandes, Dr. Atre, all the coordinators of the remote centers, all the participants. I'm really delighted to be here. I was very happy to hear the feedback from all of the participants and all the centers. Also, of course, some of the inputs coming in from heads of departments, directors of some of the institutes who were there. So first of all, let me say that I think this is really an excellent initiative, and it's really a two-pronged initiative. First, of course, it is the initiative of the photovoltaics, which I'm, of course, personally involved with, and that is how to spread this new area of photovoltaics to many more places, many teachers, and through them to many students. Of course, it's also a relatively new initiative in terms of teaching. How do you really scale up the teaching going from, let us say, a smaller place like, for example, IIT Bombay, going to many more teachers? So that, of course, is the initiative of the National Mission on Education through ICT, which Kannan just talked to you about. So I'd like to really see this particular Teacher 1000 Teachers course as a marriage of two very important trends, and that is the, of course, solar energy and photovoltaics in particular on the one side, and the very important problem of education and scaling up expertise generation on the other side. I think from all that I have seen and heard, this Teach a Thousand Teachers course has been extremely successful, and I congratulate everyone who has been involved with that. Firstly, of course, I would say first, I would like to congratulate Professor Deepak Phatak. He's not here right now. But of course, as you all know, he has played a very important role. This whole idea of 1,000 teachers, you can, of course, you can see even from the title of this program that Professor Phatak never likes to think in very small ways. He always likes to think big, and Teach a 1,000 Teachers is an example of that. And of course, we are very happy to learn from Kannan just now that he is now working on his next project and does teach 10,000 teachers on various things. So first of all, of course, congratulations to Professor Deepak Phatak. Also, I would say congratulations to the team which he has put together at IIT Bombay, which really translates his vision into reality. And as I've heard from many of you, this whole course has been very successful. You know, I heard some of you say that you doubted whether a virtual environment would work and so on. But as we can see, it has worked very well. Kannan mentioned the concept of the synchronous versus the asynchronous. I personally have no doubt that it's really the synchronous mode of education which we must take forward, because it is eventually an immersive environment in which you feel you are very much a part of the class, unlike watching a video. So I think that this experiment has really been very successful. So congrats to Professor Phatak and the Eklavya team here. And especially I must mention Dr. Mukta Atre. I know she has been interacting a lot with all of you, and she's put in a lot of effort. But also the rest of her team members, you may not have seen them directly, but they're very much there in the background, and all glitches, as soon as they arise, they're immediately taken care of. So thanks to everyone here. Of course, thanks also, obviously, to Professor Chetan Singh Solanki and Professor Fernandes for putting this all together. They've worked very hard, not only, of course, delivering the lectures, but even before that, putting this whole course together. Especially Professor Solanki has put in, you cannot imagine, huge amounts of time in getting that lab kit ready. In fact, that lab kit itself is a long story in itself, which I will not dwell upon here. And that is how to really, again, scale up lab kits, the kind of things which you have been using. If you had tried to buy commercial equivalents of that, it would have cost more than 10 times what it has cost us. So here also a question of scaling up, but scaling up keeping in mind the overall cost. And I think, again, Professor Solanki and various other investigators, various other faculty members of the National Center for Photovoltaic Research and Education here at IIT Bombay, all, and the students as well, all of them have put in effort developing these experiments and the lab kits. Thanks again to all the coordinators who visited here, of course, firstly to kind of do the dry run on these experiments, and then finally, of course, to receive them at their centers, put it all together, and of course guide all the participants through that. As of course, in fact, the ministry has also mentioned they are now very interested in seeing whether these lab kits can be replicated even further, and to see whether they can be spread out to many more colleges beyond the 35 centers. We would definitely try to see what can be done about that. But also I would say we need to see that there is a specific interest from the various colleges. And I think Professor Solanki and Professor Fernandes will be in touch with you regarding this as we go along. Of course, in one way, this was a very interesting aspect, or one very interesting example of the Teach a 1,000 Teachers course, in the sense that it really looked at a new area, that is photovoltaics. Most of the colleges really don't have a course in photovoltaics. And part of the aim really is to see whether more colleges really would like to start such a course, either as a full program or at least initially as a single elective course. And I think the response from what I saw today is that it does look very, very positive. The MNRE, and of course you saw right in the beginning that both the minister as well as the secretary were present at the inaugural session. The secretary again addressed you yesterday. They are definitely very interested in making this photovoltaics available to a larger number of colleges, and I'm sure they would be willing to fund also. So if there is enough interest from your side, I can assure you that help from our side, that is IIT Bombay and the National Center here, as well as I can say from the ministry side, will definitely be forthcoming. In one way, I would really say that all of you participants out there, the 1,000 teachers plus who attended this course, are very important, because you are the initial seed who will now go out and teach more students, and that is really the way eventually the photovoltaics will grow in the country. In fact, in a sense, India is really in a very special position. We are blessed with a lot of sunshine. Photovoltaics and other avenues or other forms of solar energy are really very important for us. Through programs like this, we can really become a world leader in solar energy, in photovoltaics. And I can see that if you and your students actually spread the mantra, we can definitely become a world leader in solar energy. Not only in terms of the teaching, the education, the research also, and also, of course, very importantly, as Professor Fernandes mentioned, photovoltaics is unique really for us, because it gives us the ability to really reach out to the far-flung areas of our country which otherwise may be deprived of electricity for years to come. In fact, in that sense, again, I draw a parallel between photovoltaics and the National Mission on Education. They both really cater to the remote areas of our country, and our country is very big. Not only cater to the remote areas, but really, in a sense, cater to the people who are less blessed with inputs than many of us. So, let's really take this photovoltaics as a mission, and I'm sure that we can succeed if we do that. Again, I would like to mention that the NCPRE, the National Center for Photovoltaics Research and Education at IIT Bombay, which was set up by MNRE, really our mandate is to reach out to all kinds of people. We have to reach out to industry, but equally important, education. Education is an important word in our name. We do want to reach out to all of the colleges and institutions all across the country and see how we can help in spreading the education of photovoltaics. So I assure you, we'll be very interested in being in touch with you, and we'll use some of Professor Moudgalya's other methods, the spoken tutorial, definitely the ask a question, to be in touch with many of you. This was a question many of you had, and we will certainly use these new techniques to keep in touch with you and for you to keep in touch with us. I would also finally like to congratulate, as you all saw, this AVU worked very well, and I would like to congratulate the team at Amrita University at Kollam, which has developed AVU, Professor Bijlani in particular, and we are able to really reach out to all of you through a fairly small bandwidth. We don't require huge bandwidths, which sometimes is necessary for high quality video conferencing. And as you all, I think, as I heard you all say, this was very successful. So congratulations also to the Amrita team for making this happen. So with these few words, and again, congratulations to all of you for really conducting the programs at the remote centers, and to all of the participants who spent full 10 days and have, I hope, benefited a lot from this course. Congratulations to all of you. I wish you all my best. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Vasi, for saying such nice things about us. We believe that we are one of the best teams in IIT. And I may be the most visible face in this team, but all these people have worked very hard to make this workshop so successful. I would like to conclude the valedictory function now with just two things to remind the participants. One of them is that your feedback is very, very valuable to us. So I request all the coordinators to make sure that all the participants give us their feedback on the Moodle. I would say that it is mandatory. So please do make sure that all the participants give us their feedback so that we can improve our workshops further. And the second thing is that Professors Solanki and Fernandes have already given you assignments for the next few days. And only when we receive those assignments and they are corrected, we would be dispatching the certificates. So make sure that all of you do hand us those assignments. And I'd like to thank all of you to join for joining us in this great workshop. We enjoyed doing this very much. Thank you.